One last one on that 2012 tour then, because and is there any truth to the, you've said it before, Sean, maybe that you told Brad not to go home? There was a point where you were ready to go home in 2012.
Yeah, I don't think I packed my bags and that, but I was like, you know, look, if we can't go on like this for 2 weeks, you know.
Yeah.
I thought we were all on the same page, you know, like if it's going to carry on, I said, I'll just go home, because I took so much stick the year before for failing and starting to get it right. I'm leading by the tour by 2 minutes. So then, you know, someone was sort of shooting bullets in a different direction to what we were trying to, and I was just like, it was just trying to understand the situation. Like all these guys, you know, Richie, Mick, they'd all sacrificed their chances for us to win the tour. I was leading by 2 minutes, and it was just because it wasn't part of the plan. I was kind of going, what's going on? And I was trying to understand the situation, I think, more than anything.
Yeah, I mean, there's definitely truth in it, you know, and Bradley was so focused. It's a fine line between, you know, when you're that focused, that motivated, you know, you can tip either way easily, some easier, more easy than others. And yeah, like Bradley said, for me, Froome went back on his word, and for me, he's not a guy I like for that reason. End of story.
And this is what Jesse was just referring to there, with Froome going off the front and Brad, you saying as DS in the Team Sky car, Froome, you better have Brad's permission for that.
Yes, because it obviously wasn't part of the plan. So I'm thinking, okay, maybe they had a chat between themselves, you know, and Brad said, this is okay. But, you know, that's why obviously I questioned him. But there was no conversation. It was not part of the plan.
Well, I think I spoke to him later, and I think what he was in his head was he was trying to get more time on Nibali, because he was...
But that wasn't our priority.
No, but in doing that, took his eye off the ball.
We had a plan, and then suddenly he got led astray. And, you know, okay, you could take it either way. He was either naive and he didn't really mean it, or this, that, and the other. But when I think of what he's done since, I think, you know, he's not that naive. And, yeah, he did but go back his word. Me, Bradley, and Dave B were in the room, in the back of the bus. We came to an agreement, and he renegaded on that agreement. End of story.